Today we won't talk about normal invasive animals like wild boars, fire ants, or wolves. This video actually focuses on species that really have the potential to wipe out entire ecosystems in the USA. Allow me to introduce you to the spotted lanternflies. The US is now gearing up for an invasion of spotted lanternflies. This invasive pest was first spotted in the US in 2014 and has since made its way to states like New Jersey, Connecticut, Maryland, Virginia, Indiana, and Ohio. They're these bugs with cute colors, but the US Department of Agriculture says to squash their eggs as soon as you spot them without hesitation. This is because it causes a hefty $324 million in annual damages. Spotted lanternflies feed on tree bark sap, which can harm the tree. These invasive pests pose a serious threat to ecosystems and vital agricultural economies, especially apple orchards and vineyards. It's not just about how much they eat, but it gets worse because after feeding, they leave behind a substance known as honeydew. This stuff is basically digested sap that attracts more pesky bugs to the tree and leads to the growth of a fungus called sooty mold. A fungus is bad news for trees as it puts them through stress, leaving them vulnerable to diseases and pests. Plus, it ruins the photosynthesis process, which slows down their growth and makes them look and feel pretty sickly. Eventually, this could lead to the tree dying. In the wilderness of Montana, the tranquil home of 85-year-old Barbara Poschke became an unexpected battleground. On September 27, 2015, the elderly woman heard an unexpected sound in her kitchen. Initially, she thought it was a thief, but unfortunately, it was a huge and ferocious bear standing before the refrigerator, feasting on its contents. When the bear noticed the old woman, it immediately attacked her, leaving her mortally wounded. Eventually, Barbara Poschke passed away due to her injuries on October 1, 2015. Although bear attacks on humans in America are relatively rare, with just one or two fatal attacks occurring each year, they have a significant economic impact. The U.S. is currently home to approximately 340,000 bears, many of which pose a threat to farms and kill hundreds of livestock each year. Since it is against the law to kill bears for any reason in America, the government is obliged to compensate farmers for the financial losses they incur, which can amount to approximately $1,000 for each head of livestock killed. In April 2022, in New York State, residents woke up to a massive flood that drowned a large part of the highway. When the authorities investigated the matter, the dam built by beavers turned out to be the reason. People usually don't like beavers for their dams. The width of the dam they build ranges from 1 meter to 100 meters. Beaver dams endanger millions of dollars worth of transportation infrastructure. When dams are built, floods can occur that wash away roads, wreck septic systems, and cause a lot of damage to farmland by flooding it. Also, it affects trout fish migration. Many times, beavers may cut down rare and very valuable trees to build the dam. Today, there are about 15 million beavers in North America. They cause annual losses for America ranging between $3 million and $5 million. So different states run programs now and then to thin out the beaver population. Back in 2019, Louisiana offered hunters $35 for each beaver tail they turned in, while Arkansas only gave out $10 per tail to hunters and trappers. It's all because beavers pose a security threat. This seemingly charming armored creature is considered among the most dangerous invasive species in Florida. Armadillos first arrived in Florida in the 1920s and 1930s, and by the early 1950s, armadillos had spread all over the state. Armadillos wreak havoc in various places like vegetable gardens, golf courses, sports fields, cemeteries, and preschools. Additionally, they're blamed for reducing the population of quails and sea turtles due to their fondness for quail and turtle eggs. People often complain about these creatures digging up their yards and searching for food. It usually searches in the ground for bugs, worms, spiders, small amphibians, reptiles, mammals, eggs, and anything edible. One armadillo can dig dozens of shallow burrows every night. In addition to this, each armadillo's smell can attract other armadillos to your home. With the population booming in recent decades, armadillos are bumping into people more often, and that's not a good thing at all as they carry leprosy-causing bacteria. Instances of leprosy have been detected in wild armadillos on multiple occasions, with approximately 80 cases of transmission to humans reported each year. Dealing with armadillos is still incredibly hard. Most methods used to fend off wild animals just don't cut it against them. There aren't any sprays, poisons, or smokes that work. Fences don't stop it either, because armadillos can dig tunnels underneath them. Even shooting at armadillos is also pointless because of his armored body. What do you think the American government should do to get rid of all these invasive animals? Tell me your thoughts below in the comments, and don't forget to leave a like if you enjoyed our video. See you very soon with a new episode.